This is for the ethics review class at Parker University. The eighth rule of the licensing board rules governs spinal screenings. One of the techniques used by doctors to recruit patients is to conduct spinal screenings outside of their facilities, outside of their office, where they interact with members of the public and conduct a brief examination to help determine whether that person may benefit from chiropractic care. The rules for spinal screenings vary quite a bit from state to state. Over the years, even within the state of Texas, they've varied quite a bit depending upon the board's concerns about practices that they may have heard about. The rule in Texas applies only to screenings that are taking place outside of the doctor's office. And the rules are very simple. I mean, the first rule is that the booth or location must display the name of the facility. Now, it kind of defeats the purpose of doing a spinal screening to not make your name very prominent. And that also goes with the second rule, which requires that you have business cards with contact information. Again, it would not make much sense to have a spinal screening and not have business cards ready and to pass those out to members of the public. The third rule is that the doctor, if they're engaged in the spinal screening, the doctor must have proof of licensure. They must be able to demonstrate to anyone who asks that they are actually licensed to practice chiropractic. The fourth rule has to do with publicity or advertising. Everything that occurs within the spinal screening needs to comply with the rules for advertising. We'll talk more about those in one of the next lectures. The doctor can delegate the spinal screening, and actually, because the spinal screening is such a simple process, it usually is not a very involved evaluation of the patient. But because it's such a simple process, this is exactly the kind of service that can be delegated to a staff member or somebody who's hired on a contract basis to perform. And I think many spinal screenings occur without the doctor being present at all. But even though the doctor's not present, the doctor needs to be certain that the person conducting the screening is properly trained and qualified, and to provide appropriate supervision for that person. I've heard stories that some doctors pay the screener based on the number of patients that are recruited into the practice. That certainly gives the person conducting the screening an incentive to maybe engage in some hard sell practices, or engage in some practices where they make false or fraudulent statements or mislead the patient to get them into your office. So that can certainly be, I think delegation is appropriate, but I also think delegation requires some careful supervision by the doctor who's making that delegation. The rule also requires that any person providing chiropractic services must have an identification tag that identifies their name and whether they're a chiropractor. Now, I think regardless of whether the person's providing chiropractic services, anyone working at a spinal screening should have a name tag. If they're not a doctor, it should not identify them as a doctor. Sometimes people who have graduated from chiropractic college but are waiting for their license will conduct these spinal screenings for other doctors. In that situation, even though the screener has received their Doctor of Chiropractic degree, because they do not have their chiropractic license from the state yet, they should not hold themselves out as having a DC. They should not hold themselves out as a doctor. And they need to be very careful about that, because they're that close to getting a license, you sure don't want to make a mistake that causes you to lose it. So very simple rules. And of course, if you don't do spinal screenings, you don't have to worry about it. But if you do engage in spinal screenings, make sure you pay attention to what the rules are, and make sure you use a current set of the rules as you make plans for a spinal screening. In the next video, we'll talk about the advertising rules.